हेलो एंड नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मायसेल्फ नीलेश शाह। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ कैन वी प्रोवाइड अ सर्कुलर ओपनिंग इन ईटैब्स एंड अलोंग विद सर्कुलर ओपनिंग वी विल सी रेक्टेंगुलर ओपनिंग आल्सो। बट बिफोर दैट, इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल, प्लीज गो एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल फॉर द मोर ईटैब वीडियोज लाइक दिस एंड स्टे अपडेटेड। नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू। We have just started a new model, so we use built-in settings, okay, and we will use the default setting of ETABS. Now what we will do is we will work in this plan view. So let us close this 3D view. Now what I will do is I will define the material properties and slab and will assign there. So as you all know how to do this, I will be doing just in the fast forward mode, and after that we will be doing the technique for opening. So let's start. Now we have defined all of our properties, that is the material and section properties. Now we will draw our columns and slabs. Okay, so now we have drawn our columns and slabs. What we will do is we will now make our column invisible for time being. So go to say display option and hide the column, apply. Okay, so we have hidden our column. Now select a joint. Okay, so we have selected a joint, and now suppose we want, let me show you something before that. Here you can see this. This is our rectangular grid system, and here is that circular opening that I want to show you there. Okay, so this center, yeah, this center is at, if I will take this at 0, 0, okay, if I will take this point at 0, 0, then from this point, then from this joint, the center of this circle is at 4, 4, yeah, that is the 4 meter in x direction and 4 meter in y direction, that is this point is here at 4, 4, and the circumference, that is the diameter of this circle is also 4 meter and the radius is 2 meter, yeah. So the point will rotate about this origin at a radial distance of 2 meter. So to make this all data in ETABS, let us see how can we do it. Now we have selected a point here. Now what we will do is we will replicate this point at the center that I told you, that is we will select this point and will replicate here at the center. The center is at 4, 4, yeah. So let us go to ETAB. Now I have selected this. I will, you can either go to edit, and you can see here there is a replicate option, or you can just simply, you can do what is Control plus R, and in x direction 4 meter and in y direction also 4 meter and the number only 1. Okay, so apply. Here you can see that you have replicated that joint here. Yeah, I have just made the joint was invisible, so I have just made the joint visible. Yeah, so I have just replicated the point here. Now, okay. Now, what we can do is we want to create a circumference about this point. The circumference that is at a radial distance of 2 meter. So for that, select this joint, go to edit, and again replicate it, keep it 2 here, or what you can do is you can do in any direction, that is you can replicate it here or here or here or here, any direction, just in the circumference, yeah. So I will replicating this at the top here, dy equals to 2 meter and the number 1, and that is the one number of joint. Now apply. Yeah, okay, so you can see that I have replicated this point here. Now what I would like to do is I would like to replicate this point radially here. Suppose this here is my center. Yeah, you can see in the 3D view that there are so many joints. Yes, those all were replicated radially. So now I'll go to e-tabs and I will select this joint, and again we'll go to edit and replicate, and in radial direction and specify. Now I will pick one point about which I would like to replicate. So I will pick one point, that is the center point, that is the center joint. I have selected this, and now the angle between the radial lines. Okay, the angle between the radial lines, suppose I will keep it 20, that is the spacing between the grid lines in T direction, transfer direction. I will take the 20 degree spacing. Okay, the spacing between two radial lines will be 20 degree. And now if we divide 360 by 20, what we will get? We will get 18 numbers. That is, if the spacing between two radial lines is 20 degree, then the number of radial lines will be 18. And now what we will do? We will apply. So you can see we have created a circumference here. Okay, yeah. Now as that we have created a circumference, we will go to draw floor plan. And in the property we will see here opening. Yeah, is by default there. And now select each of the joint carefully. Okay, now you can see here we have created a circular opening here. And now if you want to create a rectangular opening, then simply what you can do is suppose you want a rectangular opening in this slab. Yeah, so just click now let us replicate these points like we did in for circular. So after selecting the joint, Control plus R. Yeah, and what will do is one, and the number will be one. Okay, apply. So I have applied here. Now after selecting this, I will simply, what I will do is 0 and let it be 2. Apply. And now again I will select this and let it be 0, and then okay, so apply. Now I will select this and again apply. Now as I have created four joints for a rectangular opening, now I will go to draw floors and property opening, and now select the four joints here. So now here we have created all the circular openings and the rectangular openings in all the stories. Okay, so now what we'll do is we will make our joints invisible and columns visible. Apply. Okay, now we'll go to our new window, that is the 3D view. You can see all the openings are created here. To make it more personalized, let us also set display option, view colors by section properties. apply to all windows, apply, okay. And here in the 3D view, you can see the openings from top floor to the bottom floor. Here you can see this here. So in this way we can create the circular openings and rectangular openings in our slabs. So now we have done with the content for this video. And yes, please, if you're new to this YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel, because this encourages me more to make more YouTube videos like this. And please, and share with your friends, it is really useful to you. Please like the video if you really liked it. So now I would like to take a leave, and we'll see you in the next video. Stay updated and keep supporting. Lots of love to you all guys. Thank you.